Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and today I'm going to be reviewing the game Dance Factory for PlayStation 2. Dance Factory is a Dance Dance Revolution clone complete with dance mat. The difference is that Dance Factory allows you to use your own music in the game. Now, it's important to say that first off, Dance Factory, you could get it with either just the disc or the disc and the mat. Let me tell you about the mat situation. The mat itself is, first of all, it has a foam base underneath it, which is incredibly slippery. They suggest that you place the mat on a non-slip surface, such as a carpet. My whole basement where I am right now is carpeted, and quite frankly, the mat slips like you wouldn't believe. It slips more than any other mat I've used, and I own three different types of dance mats. A original Konami Dance Dance Revolution one, a third-party one made for GameStop, and that one. And I can tell you it's the worst of the three. The dimensions are not accurate. It's longer on the length than a Konami Dance Dance Revolution mat, but shorter on the width, which makes dancing rather difficult on it, trying to get your exact foot placement. So what ended up happening was I swapped out the mat and put in my original Konami Dance Dance Revolution mat, which does work. The problem with is that the Konami Dance Dance Revolution mat only has two buttons on it. Two action buttons. It has the cross and the circle. Whereas, as you can see in this little demo here, the Dance Factory mat has four. And a lot of the controls will not be accepted, not during gameplay, but menu navigation will not be accepted without that those extra buttons, primarily the triangle and the square. So let me take you through a tour of the game. Okay, here are your first set of options. First thing I'm going to do, actually I'll take you through a factory style before I do any modifications. It's important to note that unlike the Dance Dance Revolution games, which allow you to advance with both the cross and the circle, this game only allows you to go ahead with the cross. And if you notice at the bottom there, I don't know if you could see it on the screen, but back is done with a triangle. A Dance Dance Revolution mat doesn't have a triangle. So, whatever option you choose, better be the right option. The game comes prepackaged with five songs. Now, on the box, there's absolutely no mention of what the songs are. So I was certain they were going to be either unknowns or covers. To my surprise, they're all original. Not only are they all original, but they offer a selection of music for each song. So the song selection was actually very good. There's Doncha by Pussycat Dolls, Ponda Replay by Rihanna, I Like the Way by Body Rockers, which is more of a rock song, I Like It, I Love It by Tim McGraw, which is country. I own many dance games, and I've never played a country song in a dance game. And Get Down On It by Kool & the Gang, which is disco. Ponda Replay is kind of a dance pop reggae song, and Doncha is dance pop popular. I'll go through a factory shipped song to show you how it works. And we'll go through some major concerns with the game. Gonna do it in normal mode. I'll leave theme at random, because I want you to see the themes. Now, if the theme doesn't choose none by random, then we're good. Okay. The theme in the background is incredibly distracting, as you can tell. This one isn't too bad. There's one that's just a whole rainbow spectrum that's going by the screen, and it's almost impossible to play with it. If you notice, the heads-up display is rather minimal. Now, any connoisseur of the Dance Dance Revolution series will see something that glares at them right away, which is incredibly counterintuitive. If you look at the order of the arrows from left to right, it's left, up, down, right. What's the problem with this? Well, Dance Dance Revolution is left, down, up, right. So, if you plan to play Dance Dance Revolution games, or if you're accustomed to Dance Dance Revolution games, and then you come and play this, it's incredibly counterintuitive and frustrating. I left sound effects. Right now you can't hear any of them. But, because I guess I'm not doing anything. But sound effects are minimal. But what they also do is they interfere with the music. They're so loud and obnoxious that they just cover the music. I'll do some of the dance so you can see what's going on. Timing is actually good for the game, but there's so little visual effects for the actual gameplay that there's not very much feedback. You just heard a sound effect there. You'll also notice something else that's very, very troublesome about this game. The arrows, the way it's spaced out. On Dance Dance Revolution, if you play single player, your arrow segment is cornered to one side or the other, as it's an arcade game, but also because, an arcade game that facilitates two players. But it's also a lot more organized and easier to keep track of your arrows. Here they take up the whole screen and spread it out, so especially following double steps, like if you're going to jump steps, I should say, like for example doing left and right at the same time with the jump, it's very hard to track in this game due to that very thing. So there you go. Now we're going to go into the, I don't know if I got a high score, so maybe, yes I did, okay. Now you're going to see another problem with the game. I want to navigate out of here. I want to get to just song selection. I'm done with this. Enter player name. Fine. Start. Finish. I don't care. Enter player name? No, I didn't want to enter a player name. What's my option? My only option is enter player name. I absolutely have to enter a player name to continue. It could be nothing, that's no big deal. But the prompt here, enter player name, essentially means accept. But instead of using accept, they wrote enter player name again. So if you don't choose enter player name, you're not going anywhere. Okay, I don't know if you could see at the bottom there, but it says to dance to your own music, insert your music CD now. I would like to show you the main menu, or change modes. But here's the problem. I don't have a square, and I don't have a triangle. Luckily, I also plugged in a standard PS2 DualShock controller into port 1, so I can navigate this way. Gonna get rid of those game sound effects. They're obnoxious. Fine with everything else. Now, you would figure that there would be an option to change the arrows so that they could match Dance Dance Revolution and not be so counterintuitive. There's not. So that's a huge problem, and even after looking online trying to find a cheat to do it, there is no cheat for it. You're stuck with the layout they give you, which is very unfortunate. And essentially doesn't make me want to play the game, because I don't want to do something that's counterintuitive and it's going to mess me up for Dance Dance Revolution. Okay, let's do some multiplayer. Now the reason I choose multiplayer is because, as you saw, the layout of the arrows was spread across the screen, which I don't like. I would like just my arrows on my side. Bunched together on the left or right hand side. Problem is, the game doesn't offer this, so in order to do it, I have to choose multiplayer and have a non-active participant. Since there's no real... what's the word? Since there's no real failing out of the song, since it's a battle, there's no real problem, and since there's no advancement in the game, I mean, there's points you could unlock to unlock themes and whatnot, but who cares, right? Not for me. Alright, battle. Oh look, I gotta enter names again. I hate doing that. Okay, to dance to your own music, insert your CD now. Oopsie. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna eject the tray. I remove my disc and I put in a disc. Now, what's nice about the game is, and I think this is more the PlayStation 2 rather than the game itself, the game accepts copied discs. However, the copied discs have to be of a certain type. For example, this one, you won't see it in the light. Anyway, the disc that worked for me was a copied disc that had a cover layer on it, like with a brand name and written CDR and written the space and what have you. I tried a CDR with no cover surface on it, with the shiny silver surface. It didn't work out. It just didn't read it. Now, is that the game or is that the PlayStation 2? I would argue it's the PlayStation 2. So. I put in my disc, I close the tray. It's important to note that I'm using a PlayStation 2 Slim. There we go. Here's my list of songs. I happen to like song 2. I'm going to choose it. Create dance. It is now converting the song. Now the thing is that the time it takes to convert the song is the length of the song. It's literally reading the song and creating the dance. If you're converting a whole album, it's very long. They thought of something to keep you occupied. It's this game called Kubrick. What's happening here is I have this shape that I can move and rotate. And my goal is, like Tetris, to bunch certain colors together. And that will create a... it will eliminate blocks. I find the game's hard to play with the controller. The dimensions aren't easy to see. So, I'm not so much of a fan of it. But it is nice to have something to kill time as the songs encode. Once again, you'll notice the quit is represented by a triangle. I don't have a triangle on this dance mat. Luckily, I do have a controller. Ha! Guess what? I can't quit because I accepted this with the dance mat. I could get that. I'm trying every control I can to get out of this mode. Looks like I'm completely out of luck. I just reached a progression breaker. This is really unfortunate. Gotta reboot the game. I should also note that the first time I ever booted this game, for some odd strange reason, not only would it not boot, but the disc would continually spin up, spin down, and display a black screen. I waited 3 minutes, at which point I reset my machine and finally to boot it up. But I've never seen that before in my life. Not on a retail game, I should say. So this time I'm going to be a little more clever and I'm going to navigate by the DualShock 2. Okay, ejecting the disc, putting in my disc. The dance is now encoding. I'm going to make sure not to go into Kubrick. There's one other feature of this game which I haven't tried, which I'll take a look at with you on the camera, see what it's all about. It's this creature creator mode. Essentially, every CD you encode and use creates a creature, and the creatures can do battle with each other, supposedly. Something like a Pokemon or a Monster Hunter. I don't know those games very well, but I don't know, I didn't try it, I didn't care for it, I didn't care for the idea, and it required a memory card, and I didn't want to save any memory on this, but maybe I'll give it a shot on camera. Okay, so I take it back. Songs do not encode in the time of the song. I guess the first time I was doing it was just incredibly slow for some reason. That one actually went pretty quick. Alright, here we go. Oh, and you get to see a very bad background. Well, hopefully you heard the song. It was Give Me Your Money Please by Bachman Turner Overdrive. I didn't put it very loud, and maybe in hindsight I should have, because I know the microphone on this camera isn't very good. But I wanted you to be able to hear my voice over the songs, that's why I had it low. Well, there you go. If you did hear the audio, you had an idea of how the timing works in the game, how the steps are generated, charting's done per song. It worked alright. I don't know if you caught on, if you were actually hearing the song, I hope you were. But my steps were off every time there was an up and a down arrow. And that's because I'm so used to Dance Dance Revolution that it kept on throwing me. I always have to take an extra second to compute, okay, I don't press down here, I press up here. Anyway, okay, moving on. So, let's try that creature thing, see what it's all about. This is going to be live, by the way, I haven't done this yet. Put a memory card in. Okay, let's create a creature. I'm also going to choose a song, I'm not sure what it is. Great dance. I can't review the iToy portion of this game, I don't own an iToy. But then again, I've never used an iToy in any of the Dance Dance Revolution games. So I wouldn't be able to really compare it to anything. See, with points I could buy background themes. That's important. Oh, by the way, with the last background theme, I'm so glad it was that one. I hope nobody got a seizure because of it. Shows you just how difficult it is to play with that theme. Alright, let's see what this is. Whoops. I assume it's gonna make... Player 1, please insert a containing captured creature data. I don't have any creature data. Do I have to make a creature? A big pain. I guess I have to make a creature beforehand. Oh, at least I could preview the tracks. I like that. It'll do nicely, I choose it. There we go. I just created a creature using this specific disc, and this is the creature it made. I'm not sure how this works. I have a creature here. I'm not sure what he's doing either. Alright, I'm bored with that. There we go, I just loaded up some creatures. Good for me. And now I can't advance, apparently. Never mind, I had to do it on the mat as well. Here we go. Thank you. Well, that was incredibly disappointing. These battling creatures seemed to be the laziest creatures I've ever seen in my life. They did a lot of stretching and nothing else. Oh, one seems to be exploding in white goo. No comment. Well, there we go. Before I let you go, I should mention that another criticism of the terrible dance mat controller that comes with this game is that the cord is extremely short. Already the Konami Dance Dance Revolution cords are short. This is extremely short. It's shorter. So you better be really close to your machine if you want to use it, or else you risk pulling your machine to the ground. So there you go. Overall, that is Dance Factory. After this review, this is probably the last time I'm ever going to play Dance Factory. It's highly, highly disappointing. The dance mat that comes with it can be used in Dance Dance Revolution games. However, the sensors, especially for the left arrow on my dance mat, was not very responsive, and I don't know if it's even worth using. Well, there you go. That's Dance Factory. I hope this helps somebody. I hope, you know, you could use this for your information. And, yeah, I don't recommend buying Dance Factory. All right.